Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. In today's video, we are going to learn the basket weave stitch. This stitch is suitable for large projects, so you can enjoy its beauty. So let's jump into it. For the foundation row, we will chain multiples of 8. This row will consist of double crochets. So I will start the first double crochet in the fourth chain from the hook. Then work double crochets all across the row. You can pause the video now, work your double crochets, and then I will meet you again at the end. So now I've worked all my double crochets. I began with 24 chains, then skipped 3 chains, ending by 22 double crochets. For the first row, start with chain 2, turn your work, we will skip the first double crochet. So the basket weave stitch consists of front post double crochets and back post double crochets. As we know, in normal double crochets, we work in the upper part of the stitch. However, in front post and back post double crochets, we will work around the post itself. So let's begin with front post double crochet. Yarn over, insert the hook in the front right side of the post, and then take it out from the left side, so that the post will be in front of the hook. That's why it's called front post double crochet. Then you'll continue the stitch as a normal double crochet. Yarn over, pull through 2, and yarn over, pull through the last 2 loops. Again. Now add another couple of front post double crochets. Notice that the front post double crochet is pulled forward. We are now going to do 4 back post double crochets. And there is what you're gonna do. Yarn over, insert the hook in the back right side of the post, and then insert it in the left side, so that the post will be behind the hook. And that's why it's called back post double crochet. Then you'll continue the stitch as a normal double crochet. Now add 3 more back post double crochets, so we have 4 back post double crochets in total. Notice that the back post double crochet will be pulled backward, and that creates the basket weave effect. Now repeat these steps across the row. 4 front post double crochets, then 4 back post double crochets, depending on your chains count, and I will meet you again at the end of this row. So I have now reached the last stitch, and here we are going to work double crochet. I personally prefer to do it in this space. Notice that we have begun with front post double crochets and ended by front post double crochets. So no matter how many chains you have made, as long as you have worked a multiples of 8, you will end up by this. And that keeps the normal shape of the basket weave. As normal, to begin the second row, chain 2, turn your work, and instead of making 4 front double crochets, this time we will begin with 4 back post double crochet. Notice that we have now 2 rows of double crochet. These are the double crochets of the foundation row, and these are the double crochet of the first row. So choose your double crochets carefully. Skip the first double crochet and work your first back post double crochet. Then repeat 3 times. Then in next 4 stitches, you will work 4 front post double crochets.
Repeat across.
And in the last stitch, you will make a double crochet.
Now for rows 3 and 4, we will simply repeat rows 1 and 2. In other words, for row 3, you will chain 2 and begin with 4 front post double crochet, then 4 back post double crochet across the row. And for row 4, begin with 4 back post double crochet, then 4 front post double crochet across. So work these 2 rows and I shall meet you in a while. And don't forget, in the last stitch, always do a double crochet. So now let's make a quick brief as we have finished the first group. We have worked 4 rows plus the foundation row, so that rows 3 and 4 were a duplication of rows 1 and 2. For group 2, it will be the opposite of group 1. I mean that the front posts of the first group will be facing back posts in the second group, and vice versa. So there is no new rows in this group. All you have to do is reversing the rows of group 1. So now start row 5 with 4 back posts. Then 4 front posts and repeat across the row. And in the last stitch, make a double crochet. For row 6, begin with 4 front posts, skipping the first double crochet as usual. Then 4 back posts. And repeat the pattern across. And now for rows 7 and 8, simply repeat rows 5 and 6, and I will meet you then to see how the final product looks like. So now I have finished rows 7 and 8. This is the second group. As you see, it's vertical to the first group. Now if you want your project to be taller, simply repeat these 8 rows as much as you want. I think this pattern is very effective in practicing the front post and back post double crochet. As you have noticed, it's the same row repeated in different orders. So guys, if you want me to write down the pattern for you, just leave a comment below. I hope you liked this video. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up and to subscribe to my channel. And I will see you in the next video.